Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
Sorry about that, we had a little car trouble. We here, all praises. Let's go to Luke 3. We get into John the Baptist and the doctrine of repentance. Luke 3.
Topic.
Yeah, John the Baptist and the doctrine of repentance. John the Baptist was a well-rounded teacher, prophet in Israel. He taught Israel many things regarding God's commandments, right? Even taught about Christ. Okay, so we're Luke 3. All praises to the Yahweh. The name of his anointed son, Yahweh Shai of Nazareth. Get busy. Luke 3 and 1. Want to read. Alright, cool.
Luke chapter 3 and verse 1. It says, now in the 15th year of the reign of Tiberius Caesar, Pontius Pilate, being governor of Judea, and Herod being tetrarch of Galilee, and his brother Philip, the tetrarch of Iturea, and of the region of Trachonitis, and Lysanias, the tetrarch of Abilene.
Right, so this is the time when the Romans ruled. And they had control over our land. In different parts of our land, you had this, the Edomites, so-called European, controlling the land of Israel because we fell and broke God's commandments. Therefore, the Lord put nations over us. Right? Continue.
Verse 2 says, Annas and Caiaphas, being the high priests, the word of God came unto John, the son of Zacharias, in the wilderness.
Right. So this time, the word of the Most High came to John the Baptist in the wilderness. So now it's the time for John the Baptist to go and deal with Israel. And he would pave the way before Yahweh Shai, the Lord. Right? So this John the Baptist was not the prophet Elijah. He came in the spirit and power of Elijah. You see? Many say John the Baptist is you know, you got men talking about this is Bivens and Herbert Armstrong. Foolishness. Foolishness. This is John the Baptist, a powerful teacher, man. So let's read on.
Verse 3. And he came into all the country about Jordan, preaching the baptism of repentance for the remission of sins.
So that's powerful. So it's showing you John the Baptist's ministry. His message was what to Israel?
Repentance.
Repentance. That was the message. And Malachi prophesied about John the Baptist coming, paving the way before the Lord, and he, John the Baptist, will be a messenger. So his message for Israel was repent. And that's been the message. What is repentance? When we're confessing our sins and changing our ways. Well, now we're following the righteous ways or commandments of God through Christ. So we're supposed to come to repent. That's what this is about. Us changing, humbling ourselves, putting off the old man, putting on the new. Right? Continue.
Verse 4, it says, as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be brought low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough ways shall be made smooth, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God.
Right. So John the Baptist will fulfill the scriptures and prophecy. Isaiah prophesied. So Isaiah knew about the ministry of John the Baptist. So the law and the prophets promote water baptism. You understand? So let's get that, Isaiah. We can let this go. Let's go to Isaiah. Let's deal with our navigation. Isaiah 40 and 1. So Jonathan was a bad brother. John the Baptist, John. Isaiah 40 and 1.
Comfort ye my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem.
So who is the Lord's people? Jerusalem, the 12 tribes of Israel. Right? It just told us, speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem, not a city. You don't go talk to a city. So Jerusalem would be the people of the Lord, Israel. Go ahead.
And cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity her iniquity is pardoned.
See, that her iniquity is pardoned. So what has been our problem as a people? Sin. Sin. But the Lord will let us know through his prophets that he will have one to come to down the cross for our nation, the children of Israel, that we may have forgiveness of sins. And in that, we're supposed to be repentant. But before Yahweh Shai will come and die on the cross, John the Baptist had to come and teach repentance to the same people, the children of Israel. Go ahead.
For she had received of the Lord's hand double for all her sins. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough places plain.
So remember, Israel had these scriptures. They had the law and the prophets. But what was Isaiah talking about? Isaiah's talking about one crying out, that voice, one crying out in the wilderness, right? This one would be John the Baptist. We read it in Luke 3, but continue.
Verse 5, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together.
That's that salvation, which Yahweh Shai would come after John the Baptist. Go ahead.
For the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
So what does that mean? That's why we went here. That last part.
The mouth of the Lord spoken it.
Mm-hmm. That's what it said. What it mean?
Meaning it's going to come to pass, meaning it's confirmed. John the Baptist's ministry was ordained of the Most High.
So what does that show you about the Lord's prophecies? When he speaks it,
it'll come to pass.
They fulfill themselves. Did this get fulfilled?
Yep.
Yeah, through John the Baptist. So every time you read and it say, the mouth of the Lord have spoken it, I mean, once he speaks, it's a done deal. John fulfilled that, what Isaiah's talking about, right? Go to Matthew 3. So he'll show you right there through the prophecies. The Lord fulfills his prophecies. The Bible, the whole Bible go together.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Verse 5, when it says, in the glory of the Lord, that's talking about Israel seeing Christ's ministry.
Yeah, because they didn't tell us. Because didn't it tell us in Luke 3, it said, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. So when you read on in Luke 3, who came and got baptized and everything stopped? Yahweh Shai. He's our salvation. He's our salvation.
Talking about the death and resurrection.
What?
Salvation.
Christ is our salvation. He is salvation. Christ got many names. That's why it says salvation is of the Jews. Who was he talking about?
Himself.
He also says salvation is now coming to your house. Zacchaeus, right? What did Simeon say when he held the baby Christ? What did he say? Now I've seen thy
salvation.
So Matthew 3. Yeah. And 1.
In those days came John the Baptist preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, repent.
Saying what?
Repent ye.
He was telling Israel, repent. Change. You see? Read on.
For the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
What does that mean? For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Go ahead, bro.
Let's get it to where he said, repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Then I'm right here. It's me. Through me is repentance. Through me is the kingdom of heaven. You got to go through Christ.
John the Baptist is saying, through him?
You got through repentance. Through repentance. Through repentance is the way to get the kingdom of heaven.
We said, repent ye, for because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Who is the kingdom of heaven?
Christ.
Christ. Who comes after John the Baptist?
Christ.
So that's what we're saying. He had many names. The kingdom. He is the kingdom of heaven. Without him, there is nothing. He's the salvation of Israel. So John is leading Israel to Christ. See? So that's why John said, repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Then you read on in the other parts of the Gospels. Christ said the same thing. He said, now is time. Because he was on the scene. And he taught repentance. All the prophets taught repentance to Israel. Go ahead.
For this is he that was spoken of the prophet Isaiah, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight.
See, so there you go again. John was fulfilling what's written in Isaiah 40. And he would be the one crying in the wilderness of Judea and teaching Israelites repentance. Go ahead.
And the same John had his raiment of camel's hair, and a leathern girdle about his loins.
Right, so he was dressed like Elijah, with a hairy, furry garment, camel's hair, and he had a leathern girdle around his waist. Go ahead.
And his meat was locusts and wild honey.
So he would eat locusts, this is lawful, and wild honey. Go ahead.
Then went out to him Jerusalem and all Judea, and all the region round about Jordan, and were baptized of him in Jordan, confessing their sins.
So for Israel to be confessing their sins, obviously John the Baptist had to be teaching them what?
The law.
The law of God, the commandments. And Israel, this message was so powerful, it just told us that then went out to him Jerusalem, and all Judea. So Israel came in multitudes, humbling themselves to the teachings of John the Baptist, and they would get immersed in water and be confessing their sins to the Most High. Where would this ministry be located?
In Judea, in the Jordan River.
In the Jordan River. The Jordan River has rich history. Who read it? We ain't read it. We said, go read it. Let's get it. Let's get it. It's rich history. The Jordan was split three times. Or once. Many times. Let's get it the first time. Let's go to Joshua. So you can just imagine Israel getting immersed in that water, the River Jordan. That river, man, has rich history to it. So we'll read it. Joshua 3 and 1.
And Joshua rose early in the morning, and they removed from Shittim and came to Jordan.
And came where?
To Jordan.
To Jordan, meaning Israel is right by the Jordan River. Go ahead.
He and all the children of Israel and lodged there before they passed over.
And lodged right there by the Jordan River before they did what?
Passed over.
Passed over. What does that mean? Before they kept the Passover?
before they would go through the Jordan River.
Right. So Israel is just sitting there. You think they know what's about to happen?
Nope.
No. Go ahead.
And it came to pass after 3 days that the officers went through the host.
Right. So now it's been 3 days. Where were we at? Where were we at?
Camp by the Jordan River.
So 3 days we had the Jordan River. Now you got officers going through the host of Israel, right? Go ahead.
And they commanded the people, saying, when you see the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord your God, and the priests, the Levites, bearing it, then ye shall remove from your place and go after it.
So what was Israel to do?
When they would see the Ark of the Covenant and the Levites carrying the Ark, they would go before it, meaning they would go after that. The Ark would go first, and then Israel would follow the Ark.
Right. Right. Go ahead.
Verse 4, yet there shall be a space between you and it, and 1,000 cubits by measure.
2,000.
Oh, I'm sorry. About 2,000 cubits by measure. Come not near unto it, that ye may know the way by which ye must go. For ye have not passed this way heretofore.
See that? So Israel was supposed to be at a distance from the ark. Because the ark was going to guide us somewhere. Levites bearing it, bearing the ark. So we'll be at a distance and we had to follow it. What was in the ark?
The commandments. The commandments, yeah?
Right. Commandments. Aaron's rod, that bud, right? So just to name a few things. So now let's continue.
And Joshua said unto the people, sanctify yourselves, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders.
He will do what?
Wonders among you.
What it means, tomorrow the Lord going to do wonders among you, Israel.
A miracle.
Yeah, he's going to show you some power. A miracle. Go ahead.
Verse 6, and Joshua spake unto the priests, saying, take up the ark of the covenant, and pass over before the people. And they took up the ark of the covenant and went before the people. And the Lord said unto Joshua, this day will I begin to magnify thee in the sight of all Israel.
I'm about to exalt you more, Joshua, in the sight of all Israel. Go ahead.
That they may know that as I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. And thou shalt command the priests that bear the ark of the covenant, saying, when ye are come to the brink of the water of Jordan.
What's the brink?
The edge.
The edge of the water. Once the priest would touch the edge of the water, go ahead.
Ye shall stand still in Jordan.
They should stand still where?
In Jordan.
In Jordan. Go ahead.
And Joshua said unto the children of Israel, come hither and hear the words of the Lord your God.
So now Joshua talked to Israel. The 12 tribes, come here and listen to the words of the Lord. Go ahead.
And Joshua said, hereby ye shall know that the living God is among you.
This is how you going to know, Israel, that the living power is among you. Here's the sign. Go ahead.
And that he will without fail drive out from before you the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Hivites and the Perizzites and Girgashites and the Amorites. And the Jebusites.
So this is how you going to know, Israel, that the Lord is going to deal, and without fail, deal with these seven mighty nations that's greater than you. This is going to be the sign. This is it. Read on.
Behold, the Ark of the Covenant, even the Lord of all the earth, passeth over before you into Jordan.
So what would be the sign? That the Lord would destroy the seven Hamitic nasty nations for Israel.
That Ark of the Covenant would go before Israel through the Jordan.
That's right. And that mug opened, would open up. The Lord said, go get them. The nation will be scared, brother, because the nation will know about the power of the Most High. And he will be with us. The nation downplayed this stuff. They downplay the mighty powers and works of the Most High. And they show you some foolishness at Universal Studios and all this garbage. And they park the ocean, the little thing. Then some mechanical shark come at it. Stupid. And they make these foolish movies to downplay the power of the Most High. See? But read on.
Verse 12. Now therefore take ye 12 men out of the tribes of Israel, out of every tribe a man. And it shall come to pass, as soon as the soles of the feet of the priests that bear the ark of the Lord of all the earth.
The Lord of who?
All the earth.
The Lord of all the earth, because he's the Lord who controls the whole earth. The elements and everything that comes within this earth. Go ahead.
Shall rest in the waters of Jordan, that the waters of Jordan shall be cut off from the waters that come down from above, and they shall stand upon a heap.
What does that mean? These waters shall stand upon a heap. Split.
Split.
And be up.
Like Moses.
That's right. See? Because he's the Lord of all the earth. He can do whatever he wants. He's the one who created the earth and all that, and the waters to his son, Yahushua. They have to have that wisdom. Continue.
And it came to pass when the people removed from their tents to pass over Jordan, and the priests bearing the Ark of the Covenant before the people. And as they that bear the Ark came unto Jordan, and the feet of the priests that bear the Ark were dipped in the brim of the water, for Jordan overflowed all his banks at the time of harvest.
What does that mean, Jordan overflowed all his banks? I mean, the waters are high, right?
Right.
You got deep waters. Then it say, at the time of harvest. What was the time of harvest? Hold that. Go to 1 Chronicles. This would be the time when Jordan overfloweth his banks. During the time of harvest. 1 Chronicles 12, coming back, and 14.
These are the sons of Gad, captains of the host. One of the least was over 100, and the greatest over 1,000. These are they that went over Jordan in the first month.
In the what?
Jordan in the first month.
So what's the first month?
Abib.
Abib. What season would that be?
Spring.
Spring. So what time did we go out of Egypt and go through the Red Sea?
Spring.
Springtime. Same time, same season. So it's happening again, but this time we're going through different waters. We're going through the Jordan River, right? Go ahead.
When it had overflown all his banks.
See? The wheat harvest. Time of harvest. So you can understand. Go ahead.
And they put to flight all them of the valleys, both toward the east and toward the west.
So let's go back. So we know it's the same exact time. Springtime, because once we would enter the land, man, the manna would stop.
Right.
We would keep Passover. So the Lord is on time, on point. You understand? So we going back, Joshua 3 and 15.
It says, and as they that bear the ark were come unto Jordan, and the feet of the priests that bear the ark were dipped in the brim of the water, for Jordan overflowed all his banks at the time of harvest, that the waters which came down from above stood and rose up upon an heap very far from the city Adam that is beside Zeratan, and those that came down toward the sea of the plain, even the salt sea, failed and were cut off, and the people passed over right against Jericho.
Look at that. So Israel, our whole nation, walking through dry land, right against Jericho. Who's in the city of Jericho? Heathen.
Heathens.
Them nations.
That's right.
The Girgashites, the Canaanites, and all them. And they hearing. Can you imagine that? A nation is coming, and just for the Jordan River is opened up for them, we in trouble. They was in trouble. The Lord said, I'm leading you, Israel, to this land. You about to conquer nations. This our God, man. This is our history. That's what I say. Let's get in it. This is rich history that they don't want you to know. Get into these stats. That's what they want us to know.
That president.
Yeah. Get into this man's garbage. We coming back. All praises. Let's continue.
Verse 17. And the priests that bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord stood firm on the dry ground in the midst of Jordan.
Is that powerful? So what's happening? What's happening?
The priests that carried the ark, it said they stood firm on dry ground because the Jordan is a river whose banks would overflow in the spring. So the people was on dry ground. That's a miracle because the water is on heaps on each side, just like during the time of the Exodus of Egypt.
Right. And he had a priest stop.
Yep.
Israel passing them up. Wait a minute. These waters might come. Now that ark, but his commandments in there. No. So you imagine Israel passing the priests up. They just still stuck on dry ground. That's what the Lord told them to do. That's faith. Go ahead.
And all the Israelites passed over on dry ground until all the people were passed clean over Jordan.
See?
Clean.
So they stuck right there. Israel got to get all up out of there on dry ground. The priest still there with the ark. See? He doing all that for our nation to conquer, right? Fourth chapter.
And it came to pass when all the people were clean passed over Jordan that the Lord spake unto Joshua, saying, take you 12 men out of the people, out of every tribe and men, and command you them, saying, take you hence out of the midst of Jordan, out of the place where the priest's feet stood firm, 12 stones, and ye shall carry them over with you, and leave them in the lodging place where ye shall lodge this night.
So you have 12 brothers from one from each tribe, go get stones that was at the bottom of Jordan. Each one, 12 stones representing the 12 tribes of Israel, and carry them right where they would be lodging at, camping out at, right before Jericho, the land. See, go ahead.
Then Joshua called the 12 men whom he had prepared for the children of Israel out of every tribe a man. And Joshua said unto them, pass over before the ark of the Lord your God into the midst of Jordan, and take ye up every man of you a stone upon his shoulder, according unto the number of the tribes of the children of Israel, that this may be a sign among you.
What's the this?
Those 12 stones.
Those 12 stones, landmarks. See? Go ahead.
That when your children ask their fathers in time to come, saying, what mean you by these stones? Then ye shall answer them that the waters of Jordan were cut off before the ark of the covenant of the Lord. When it passed over Jordan, the waters of Jordan were cut off, and these stones shall be for a memorial unto the children of Israel forever.
Go ahead.
And the children of Israel did so as Joshua commanded, and took up 12 stones out of the midst of Jordan, as the Lord spake unto Joshua, according to the number of the tribes of the children of Israel, and carried them over with them unto the place where they lodged, and laid them down there.
Go ahead.
And Joshua set up 12 stones in the midst of Jordan, in the place where the feet of the priests which bear the Ark of the Covenant stood.
So Joshua also set up 12 other stones right into the Jordan, that dry land, where the priests stood at. Go ahead.
And they are there unto this day. For the priests which bear the ark stood in the midst of Jordan
the whole time,
until everything was finished that the Lord commanded Joshua to speak unto the people, according to all that Moses commanded Joshua.
So was them brothers, the priests, the Levites, chilling in the midst of the Jordan?
They was chilling
the whole time, that everything would be finished. They couldn't move. Go ahead.
And
the last part, yeah.
And the people passed, and the people hasted and passed over. And it came to pass when all the people were fleeing passed over, that the ark of the Lord passed over, and the priests in the presence of the people. And the children of Reuben, and the children of Gad, and half the tribe of Manasseh passed over armed before the children of Israel, as Moses spake unto them. About 40,000 prepared for war.
Prepared for what?
War.
Prepared for what?
War.
War against who?
The heathen nations.
The heathen nations. The Canaanites, Girgashites. See? All them ites. Gonna get dealt with. Go ahead.
Pass over before the Lord unto battle to the plains of Jericho. On that day the Lord magnified Joshua in the sight of all Israel, and they feared him as they feared Moses all the days of his life.
So right there, how'd the Lord do it? Magnify, exalt Joshua, because guess what? Joshua said, this is what's going to happen, Israel. This is going to be the sign tomorrow before your eyes that you're going to destroy the Canaanites, the Girgashites, Jebusites, the Perizzites, right? This river gonna open up. So once we walking through, it's on. It was on, man. And then what would happen to Jericho? We'll walk around the city 7 times. Blow that horn, them walls came tumbling down, and what do? We went to work. See that? Let's continue.
On that day, the Lord magnified Joshua in the sight of all Israel, and they feared him.
You mean he respected him? Go ahead.
As they feared Moses all the days of his life. And the Lord spake unto Joshua, saying, command the priests that bear the ark of the testimony that they come up out of Jordan. Joshua therefore commanded the priests, saying, come ye up out of Jordan. And it came to pass, when the priests that bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord were come up out of the midst of Jordan, and the soles of the priests' feet were lift up unto the dry land, that the waters of Jordan returned unto their place, and flowed over all his banks as they did before.
Ain't that cold? Once the priests got up out of there, hit dry land, here come the waters of Jordan coming back together again. The guy split. And then Elijah with his mantle, wouldn't he split him again? And then he got taken up. And then Elisha to go back.
He put the mantle in the water.
And split him again. That's 3 times. Right? So there's a lot of history with the River Jordan. They make these songs. Man. Go ahead. Verse 19.
And the people came up out of Jordan on the 10th day of the first month.
In the 10th day of the what?
First month.
First month. Springtime. 10th day. First month. What would happen on the 14th day, young brothers, of the first month? At even. Thank you. Glad we answered that. It's coming up, right? All right. Go ahead.
And encamped in Gilgal.
Encamped in where?
Gilgal, in the east border of Jericho. And those 12 stones which they took out of Jordan did Joshua pitch in Gilgal.
Hold that. So the key word, Gilgal. So that's where Joshua then put them 12 stones, in Gilgal. So let's show the people how Moses knew all this. Go to Deuteronomy 11. So everything Moses was instructing our people about, we were supposed to do. So Joshua was a man in order, who can listen real well, follow instructions. He would hear what his brother was saying because the Most High would be speaking through, telling Moses what to tell the people. So this is Deuteronomy 11. And get you the verse. Deuteronomy 11 and 29. This is Moses speaking to our nation.
And it shall come to pass.
And it shall what?
And it shall come to pass.
So every time we hear this, the only book on the face of the earth always talking about it shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. These are how the prophets spoke. Why? Because they were speakers for the Most High. This is a book of prophecy. So it said, Moses said, it shall come to pass, continue,
when the Lord thy God hath brought thee in unto the land whither thou goest to possess it, that thou shalt put the blessing upon Mount Gerizim, and the curse upon Mount Ebal.
And the curse upon Mount Ebal. Go ahead.
Are they not on the other side, Jordan?
What are the they that Moses is talking about? Are they not on the other side of Jordan? What are the they?
Mount Gerizim and Mount Ebal.
Right. Are not these two mountains on the other side of Jordan, Israel?
Yeah.
Continue.
By the way, where the sun goeth down, in the land of the Canaanites, which dwell in the champion over against Gilgal.
Over against where?
Gilgal.
Didn't we just hear that word in Joshua the 4th chapter? Go ahead.
Besides the plains of Moreh, for ye shall pass over Jordan.
You shall do what?
Pass over Jordan.
For you shall, Israel, pass over Jordan. Go ahead.
To go in to possess the land which the Lord your God giveth you, and ye shall possess it and dwell therein. And ye shall observe to do all the statutes and judgments which I set before you this day.
See that? So Moses was being prophetic. Y'all gonna pass over to Jordan. Through a miracle, by the power of the Most High, through a miracle, right? You're going to get the land, and when you get the land, you observe the Lord's statutes and commandments. That's what he was telling our nation. And when we would pass over to Jordan, the tribes would get split, and you would have where you would have six tribes would be on Mount Gerizim, and six would be on Mount Ebal. When they be talking about what? Blessings, curses. Why? Because the blessings would come if we would keep the commandments, we become a great people and rule the earth. The curse would come, Deuteronomy 28, where we will fall. See? And what happened? We went in, broke God's commandments, now we're under the curses. The Lord wasn't playing with us. We didn't listen. So go to Deuteronomy 27. Deuteronomy 27. So can you imagine, Israel, all the words that Moses was saying was coming to pass during the time of Joshua? So you tell me the words of God ain't true? Yeah. So Deuteronomy 27. And one, this is what Moses would command our people to say, look, when you pass over Jordan, now you're going to have to make an altar. See? And he would instruct us on how to do it. Deuteronomy 27 and 1.
And Moses with the elders of Israel commanded the people, saying, keep all the commandments which I command you this day.
So what did Moses and the elders tell us? What commandment did they give us? Young brothers.
Ten Commandments.
So what did Moses and the elders, what did they command us? Who knows?
To keep his judgments in the statute.
Okay. It's standing right there in the verse. Mm-hmm. What did Moses and the elders command us?
To keep all God's commandments.
There it is. Capital K, E, right there in the verse. Keep all the commandments which I command you this day. That's what they commanded us. They're saying if we...
Therefore, keep and do them, right?
27 and 1. Deuteronomy 27 and 1.
Okay,
yeah. So it said, and Moses with the elders of Israel commanded the people, saying, what?
Keep all the commandments.
Right, which I command you this day. That was the commandment. For us to keep all the commandments of the Lord that we will receive this day.
Just check it.
Verse 2.
And it shall be on the day when you pass over Jordan.
When you do what?
Pass over Jordan.
Pass over Jordan. It shall be. It shall be on the day when you pass over Jordan. Go ahead.
Unto the land which the Lord thy God giveth, that thou shalt set thee up great stones, and plaster them with plaster. And thou shalt write upon them all the words of this law.
So these stones will be stones used to make the altar. And these stones will be plastered. That's cold. Go ahead.
And thou shalt write upon them all the words of this law when thou art passed over.
When thou pass over. Pass over what?
Jordan.
Jordan. Okay, go ahead.
That thou mayest go in into the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee, a land that floweth with milk and honey, as the Lord God of thy fathers have promised thee.
See? So the Lord keeps his oaths. He made promises with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob that he would give their seed the land. And he would do it by miraculous ways, powerful ways. And we would take our nations. Let's continue.
Verse 4, therefore it shall be when ye be gone over Jordan, that ye shall set up these stones, which I command you this day in Mount Ebal, and thou shalt plaster them with plaster. And there shalt thou build an altar unto the Lord thy God.
And where will we have to build an altar with these stones at? Where?
Mount Ebal.
There you go. Mount Ebal. Is it not by Gilgal? Okay, go ahead.
And there thou shalt build an altar unto the Lord thy God, an altar of stones. Thou shalt not lift up any iron tool upon them.
See, so we could never use a tool and start making a design with the stones. That's against the law. So yeah, these heathen come by. Yeah, the altar and this and that. The devil.
Let's continue.
It says, verse 7. And thou shalt offer peace offerings.
Verse 6.
And thou shalt put the altar of the Lord thy God of whole stones, and thou shalt offer burnt offerings thereon unto the Lord thy God. And thou shalt offer peace offerings, and shalt eat there, and rejoice before the Lord thy God. And thou shalt write upon the stones all the words of this law very plainly.
Very what?
Plainly.
Plainly. Very plainly. So on the stones and all that you had the curses, the blessings, all those will be reminders. Go ahead.
And Moses and the priests, the Levites, spake unto all Israel, saying, take heed and hearken, O Israel, this day thou art become the people of the Lord thy God. Thou shalt therefore obey the voice of the Lord thy God and do his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day.
So the people of the Lord, Israel, is supposed to do what?
Obey the voice of the Most High, power, keep his commandments. That's that.
That's what we're supposed to do as God's people. The whole time. It ain't changed. So us as the people of God, we're supposed to be about God's commandments, man. We supposed to be following his son, Yahawashi, right? That's what the Lord commanded us to do. Continue.
And Moses charged the people the same day, saying, "These shall stand upon Mount Gerizim to bless the people when ye are come over Jordan, Simeon and Levi and Judah and Issachar and Joseph and Benjamin."
See, six tribes that we just read about right there would stand upon Mount Gerizim once we were passed over Jordan. Go ahead.
"And these shall stand upon Mount Ebal to curse Reuben, Gad, and Asher, and Zebulun, Dan, and Naphtali."
That's the other six. So let's go back to Joshua. So did Moses know about us passing over Jordan and the rivers, the waters split?
Prophecy.
Remember, Moses was up with the Lord for 40 days and 40 nights. He seen many things. He knew we was going to go off as a people. He told us. That's why he came with the song of Moses. So Joshua, chapter 4, and 20. Well, y'all read verse 19. Sorry about that.
"And the people came up out of Jordan on the 10th day of the first month, and encamped in Gilgal, in the east border of Jericho. And those 12 stones which they took out of Jordan did Joshua pitch in Gilgal. And he spake unto the children of Israel, saying, When your children shall ask their fathers in time to come, saying, What mean these stones? Then ye shall let your children know, saying, Israel came over this Jordan on dry land."
Oh, go ahead.
"For the Lord your God dried up the waters of Jordan from before you, until ye were passed over, as the Lord your God did to the Red Sea, which he dried up from before us, until we were gone over."
Why would the Lord do all these mighty acts for our nation? Right here.
"That all the people of the earth..."
What does that mean? Oh, sorry about that. All the people of the earth.
Meaning all these nations.
That's right. The whole world may know. Go ahead.
"That the hand of the Lord, that it is mighty, that ye might fear the Lord your God forever."
That's right. So the Lord will always show us mighty signs. He wanted the whole earth to know how powerful he is. What do you think will happen the second time?
They don't know.
They won't recognize the God of the Hebrews, man. He's powerful. He's powerful. We just be going through different things in this kingdom, this captivity here, that Satan be working. Satan be at work. So go to Joshua 8. Joshua the 8th chapter. And 30. Let's see if Joshua was obedient. Man who followed instructions. Joshua 8 and 30.
"Then Joshua built an altar unto the Lord God of Israel in Mount Ebal."
And where?
Mount Ebal.
Mount Ebal, right? So that's there in Gilgal still. You read that in the 9th chapter. What did Moses say? Not these two mountains, right? On the other side in Gilgal. Continue.
Verse 31. "As Moses, the servant of the Lord, commanded the children of Israel, as it is written in the book of the law of Moses, an altar of whole stones, over which no man had lifted up any iron, and they offered thereon burnt offerings unto the Lord, and sacrificed peace offerings."
So here we are. Well, we destroy nations, more of them than these nations. We rejoice. Altar getting built with whole stones, as it is written in the book of the law. Did not Joshua study it?
Yep.
How do we know? Young brothers. How do we know Joshua studied at Word?
Because
what did the Lord tell him?
This book was a lost and other part out of that mountain.
There you go. Where you at?
Joshua 1 and 8.
Joshua 1 and 8?
Yeah.
That's right. And Joshua will be obedient. That's how we become successful. Through following the orders written, man. See? So let's read on. Verse 32.
And he wrote there upon the stones a copy of the law of Moses, which he wrote in the presence of the children of Israel.
And all that Deuteronomy 27? Yeah, and he wrote there, meaning on Mount Ebal, right? On the stones, a copy of the law of Moses, which he wrote in the presence of the children of Israel. Go ahead.
And all Israel and their elders and officers and their judges stood on this side the ark, and on that side, before the priests, the Levites, which bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord, as well as the strangers.
So at this time, what do we have amongst us? Right, that's right. Wrap them up. They're amongst us. Now, can you imagine that? We read, we're going to hear about the curses and the blessings. And then you will hear about, and the stranger that is among you shall get up above you very high. And y'all will come low. You don't even want to believe that. Now who's the head and who's the tail?
The nations is the head and the tail.
See? We under them curses.
Like in Psalms, was it the kings are on the horses, the slaves are on horses and the kings are on.
Yeah, in Ecclesiastes?
Yeah.
Right. Go ahead, brother.
Verse 33. And all Israel and their elders and officers and the judges stood on this side of the ark, and on that side before the priests, the Levites, which bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord, as well the stranger, as he that was born among them, half of them over against Mount Gerizim, and half of them over against Mount Ebal. As Moses, the servant of the Lord, had commanded before.
As Moses, the servant of the Lord, had commanded what?
Before.
What does that mean? Commanded before.
Meaning before it happened.
That's right. In the past, Moses said, look, remember Deuteronomy 27, half the tribe, six of you be on Mount Gerizim, the other half be on Mount Ebal, right? Presenting the blessings and the curses. We're strangers there now. Go ahead.
That they should bless the people of Israel. And afterward, he read all the words of the law, the blessings and the cursings, according to all that is written in the book of the law. There was not a word of all that Moses commanded, which Joshua read not before all the congregation of Israel, with the women and the little ones and the strangers that were conversant among them.
Look at that. I mean, amongst us, these nations, we have nations amongst us at this time. And guess what? Now we're rehearsing the blessings and the curses. That's cool. So we went here to show us this. Did Jordan got rich history to it?
Very.
So we go back to Matthew 3. Matthew 3.
And 5.
Yes, sir.
So those nations that was conversing amongst us during the time of Joshua at this time was the nations that we was going over to conquer. Is that correct?
Yeah. But then we're going to go, when you read the next chapter, the Gibeonites and all that, and we made them into hewers of wood because we took an oath.
Right.
They tricked us. But it was, these nations would be our servants. But what happened? It changed. We became the slaves. So if you just keep it simple, that's all. Matthew 3 and 5. So on your own, Israel, go back and read all that history. We got a lot to read. Just look how big Victor's Bible is, man. We got a lot to think about, man. Matthew 3 and 5.
Then went out to Jerusalem and all Judea and all the region round about Jordan, and were baptized of them in Jordan, confessing their sins. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism, He said unto them, O generation of vipers.
What did John the Baptist call these group of Israelites here called Pharisees and Sadducees? They came. You think they came to change?
Nope.
Why they there? Playing games.
Mocking.
See? You always had that element where you got snakes. That's why he called them poisonous vipers. You know what a viper is? A deadly snake, man. These guys here was not, many of them didn't want to change. They was caught up in their ways. They were covetous, right? Didn't Christ call them that? They would go after other gods. They were proud. So hold that right there. Go to Matthew 21. See, they would be there. You think they want to get immersed in that water? Hmm? No. No. Hard-headed, rebellious, stiff-necked. See, John the Baptist, they caught his attention. Okay, look who's here. The Lord wasn't playing. Spiritual, right? So Matthew 21 and 23, these guys were there to challenge Yahushua. They would challenge the men of the Lord. That's the spirit they had. They wasn't humble. It was about challenging. So Matthew 21:23.
And when he was coming to the temple, the chief priests and the elders of the people came unto him as he was teaching.
As he was what?
Teaching.
As he's teaching. Now here these guys come. You think they there to learn? No. Go ahead.
By what authority doest thou these things? And who gave thee this authority?
See that? Who gave you this authority to teach? See, they challenging him because they don't respect him as the Messiah. They don't respect Yahushua. They're against Yahushua. They're Antichrist. Where do you get this authority from? Read on.
And Yahushua answered and said unto them, I also will ask you one thing.
All right, I'm going to ask you one question to me. I got a question for you. Go ahead.
Which if you tell me, I likewise will tell you by what authority I do these things. The baptism of John.
The baptism of John.
Whence was it?
Where did it come from?
From heaven.
Did it come from heaven? Is it spiritual? Was it ordained by the Father? Go ahead.
Or of men.
Or is it carnal? Is it of men? Go ahead.
And they reasoned with themselves, saying, if we shall say from heaven, he will say unto us, why did ye not then believe him?
Look at that. See, they wicked, man. They're just there. Causing trouble, right? Not trying to change and repent, because what was John the Baptist's ministry? What was his doctrine?
Repentance.
What was his message?
Repentance.
Repentance. Change. I don't want to. I'm here, but I don't want to change. And the Lord is having his light shine. I'm knocking. If you don't change, judgment. Mm-mm. No, it's not. Yes, it is. Take God for a joke. We always say it. This is not a religion. Can't make this up. So look at them reasoning among themselves. Go ahead.
But if we shall say of men, we fear the people, for all hold John as a prophet.
So these guys were about covering up. They were phony baloney type Israelites, right? It wasn't sincere. They just put off the appearance like they righteous men. See, all the people of Israel see John as a prophet. How are you fearing the people? Who should they be fearing? Who's their God? The devil. They should be fearing the Most High, right? They just said out of their own mouth, we fear men. So when you had a fear of man, who you go? You're gonna always put on that persona that I'm in here for sincerity. No. We're supposed to be here to serve the Most High, the Father, through Christ. You checking these cats out? Need some jokers. My brother always say, need you jokers. Go ahead.
And they answered Yahweh and said, we cannot tell.
What do they mean? We cannot tell me, we ain't gonna tell you. That's what they saying, pride. So watch what Yahweh said.
And he said unto them, neither tell I you by what authority I do these things.
See, I ain't gonna tell you, jokers. You wanna tell me, I ain't gonna tell you. So sometimes you see Christ knew, okay, I gotta answer your question. He picked his battles. See? So he shut them down. Now watch, he cut them right here. Go ahead.
But what think you?
Well, what think you? Now I ain't gonna get into their reasoning. What think you? Go ahead.
A certain man had two sons, and he came to the first and said, son, go work today in my vineyard. He answered and said, I will not. But afterward he repented.
But afterward he did what?
Repented and went.
See, what did this first son have? A change of what?
Heart.
He changed. He repented and went. See. Go ahead.
And he came to the second and said likewise. And he answered and said, I go, sir. And went not.
See, and he answered, the second son said, he answered and said, I go, sir, and went not. Because his second son is what? Rebellious. Right? So he asked him this question. He said, what y'all think about this, you Pharisees? Go ahead.
Whether the twain did the will of his father?
Which two of them, out of them two, did the will of their father? Go ahead.
They say unto him, the first.
They said unto him, the first. They cut themselves. Mm-hmm. Why they say the first? Remember what Christ said? What word did he use?
Repent.
He repented. So they just cut themselves. The first one. What should have they been doing?
Repenting.
Right.
Missed the point.
Go ahead.
Yahweh said unto them, verily I say unto you, that the publicans and the harlots go into the kingdom of God before you. For John came unto you in the way of righteousness, and ye believed him not. Mm. But the publicans and the harlots believed him. And ye, when ye had seen it, repented not afterward, that ye might believe him.
See that? So these same guys were right there during the time of John the Baptist, and they wasn't there to repent, but they showed up. We want to get it, we want to have that spirit. That's the devil. We're supposed to come to change and learn, right? Humble down and do the will of a father through Christ. That's what it's about. Scriptures go out, we're supposed to humble ourselves and do what the Lord is instructing us to do. Hear ye him. Christ said, get in that water, didn't he? See? And get immersed. That water baptism, that's a part of the ministry of Christ. It represents us putting off the old man and putting on the new, which is Christ. So we come out of that water, we looking to live that new life and grow in that. We don't challenge it. Because then we got the spirit of the scribes and Pharisees, right or wrong?
Same spirit.
Because now we're challenging Christ's authority. See, it's spiritual. So we go back to Matthew 3. Matthew 3 and 7.
Matthew chapter 3, verse 7.
Right.
But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism.
But when he did what?
When he saw many of the Pharisees.
Two.
Many.
Three.
Many.
Five.
But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees.
So it was many of these jokers up in there. Right? Called Sadducees and Pharisees. Different groups of Israelites. Go ahead.
Come to his baptism, he said unto them, O generation of vipers, who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come?
Who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come. What is the wrath to come that John the Baptist know about?
Eternal destruction.
That's right. That fire that's coming to this earth at Christ's second coming. When he come with his mighty angels, it's called the baptism of fire for unrepentant Israelites. You see? Malachi spoke about it. Go to Malachi 4 and 1. He spoke about it. The prophets knew about judgment day. Who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Y'all know what's coming to this earth, Israel? God's what?
Wrath.
Wrath. So you think the Lord is happy with man? You think his son is happy with man? What is man doing? What is Israel doing? Partying. Being covetous, reveling, out there fighting. Murdering one another, selling drugs to one another, not just selling them, taking drugs. Right? We living how we want to live on the earth, and we think it's all right with God. So what do you think also? Oh, once we fall on sleep and into the earth, the wrath, do you save from the wrath? Or are you burning underground? What's happening? Satan poking you? The dead? Is Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and all that looking down on, hey, we made it. What scripture is that? Wouldn't they be rewarded already and have wings and be up there? We received our reward. We just waiting on the rest of Israelites. When Hebrews 11 cut the whole devil doctrine, it say they ain't received the reward yet. That whole chapter cuts them because Paul is talking about people have already passed away, did he not?
Right.
Then he went from the beginning.
Right.
See, so nobody has been rewarded yet. Ezra brought it out. He said, then the names of the righteous shall be declared after death, at the resurrection. That's what he's talking about. So you got Malachi 4 and 1.
Malachi 4 and 1. For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven.
So what day is Malachi talking about?
Judgment day.
That's right, judgment day. And this day is dealing with fire. Did it say icy, what they call them?
ICBMs.
Silos and Russia bombing America and this and that. And you'll be missile fool Israel. You'll be running from the missiles. So they didn't watch Terminator too many times. This how it's gonna be. Look, see. This day coming, Israel. Remember the Lord, he fulfilled his prophecies. Do we know the day? The hour and the time?
No, man. No man. Not even the sun.
But it's coming. And it's going to catch many people by surprise. Christ said it's going to come like a snare upon the earth. What's a snare?
Trap.
Trap. Something you can't see. Wham! Get you. Just like that. Go ahead.
It says, for behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven. And all the proud.
All the who?
The proud.
The proud. What was these brothers here called? Pharisees and Sadducees.
Proud.
Yeah, that's why John the Baptist said, who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Should we want to run around with the pride of life?
No.
Yeah, all the proud, go ahead.
Yeah. And all that do wicked.
And all that do what?
Wicked.
Where you at, Yahweh?
Malachi 4:1.
Is this the law and the prophets?
Yes.
So what dictates, not man's mind, what dictates man of wicked from the law and the prophets? What will make man wicked?
The breaking of God's commandments.
That's right. Because we're in the law and the prophets. So that go to show you right there. Man want to continue to break God's laws That's how we'll get caught. What they told us, the laws is done away with. Mm. We don't have to keep the Sabbath. We play with that, don't we?
Yeah.
Take it lightly. See? Children gotta honor their father and mother. Parents have to teach them to honor father and mother. Respect authority. We take that lightly as a people. Gang bang. Right? We're going after other gods. It's only one power. The Father. What else are we doing? Going on the streets with graven names, images and poster boards, right?
Right.
And if you don't bring seizure boards here out there to the camp, you're gonna be on punishment for 30 days, 3 months. You forgot to sign, you out the zone, you out the spirit. Go home. You feeling bad?
You're gonna destroy me, man. Because that's the door of truth.
And they got idols. See? And that's what they say, home of truth. They the home of the truth, yeah. Come through these doors. They going into John 10, the door, read it again, the door. Christ said, I'm the door. The door! You're gonna get kicked down these stairs. That's the door. Foolishness. And then you gotta split. Brother, no. You gotta split. But this is David, King David, Paul, and you got splits. Serious? It's a gimmick, it's a scam, Israel. We have to repent, man. You see what the Lord's telling us through his prophets? Repent. That is it. For a lot of our people, we don't like the message. We don't like the gospel. We'll be caught out there. So read it again, brother. So you always want to remember, that's the law and the prophets. And yeah, all that do wickedly,
just say, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble.
Shall be what?
Stubble.
Stubble. What's stubble? Straw. Mm-hmm. You know when fire hits straw, what happens? That should put fear in us, man. Or do we don't believe that? See, our people run around calling themselves Christian, but you rarely hear this message. Oh, y'all got the doctrine of doom. Oh, this is gloom, man. These are things that save our souls. This is a warning. Who we want to hear?
Smooth.
That's it. Smooth things. Change. They talking about me. Then we get pissed. The scriptures go for all of us. None of us is above the scriptures, right or wrong?
Right.
No man is above the scriptures. No woman is above the scriptures. No child is above the scriptures. So read that again.
It say, for behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yea, and all that do wickedly, shall be stubble. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root
not
nor branch.
Neither what?
Root nor branch.
Remember those words, root or branch. See, the John's gonna pull it. And these jokers can't catch on. Go all right with their head, la la land. That's what John was teaching, repentance. See, you got Israel today talking about the baptism of the fire is a good baptism. They lead our people right to hell, right? Mm-hmm. What hell are we talking about? Hellfire. That's the good one you want. No, we don't. You don't think we lying? I ain't saying y'all do, but that's what's out there. Garbage. So Matthew 3 and 7.
Matthew chapter 3, verse 7. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism, he said unto them, O generation of vipers, who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bring forth, therefore,
fruits meet for repentance.
See that? Bring forth, therefore, fruits meet for repentance.
What are these fruits? The fruits of the Spirit, man. So what's your, anybody had that little center column?
Say, where it say meet for repentance.
Yeah, what does that say?
It say answerable to amendment of life.
Answerable to amendment or change of life, change of lifestyle. Mm. So our lifestyle has to change and be according to what? The scriptures, according to Christ.
Book of the law.
Hmm?
Book of the law, not faithfulness.
Christ is our righteousness. What was Christ at on the Sabbath then? In the synagogue, keeping the Lord's Sabbath, right?
Right.
Christ was about the commandments of his Father, right?
Right.
Did Christ get in that water?
Yeah.
Yeah, so who are we? We're supposed to be the followers of who?
Christ.
Christ. What are we doing? See, a lot of them joking out there. Oh, that's European Christianity. That's you saying that. And you the main one going around there pushing European Yiddish. Right? And all this other foolishness, man. Talking about some Lashawana Kwadash, okay? But this day, this was their attitude right here. So John was cutting them. Go ahead, verse 9.
And think not to say within yourselves, we have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you that the Most High is able of these stones to raise the children unto Abraham.
And Abraham do have children. The seed, the righteous seed, Peter, James, Paul, Mary, Martha, see, Tabitha. Brothers and sisters that's repentant. Lord raising up Abraham's children. But these guys' attitude was what?
Proud.
Proud. We got Abraham. We Israel.
Children of the promise.
We don't have to change. We the children of promise. We don't have to listen to you, John the Baptist. We don't want to hear that message of repentance. We ain't getting in that water. See, this is how the prophets always have to deal with wicked Israelites that's like this, rebellious. The whole time. They didn't want to change. Hold that, show you an example. Go to Ezekiel. Ezekiel 33 and 23. The Lord, man, be speaking to us. Ezekiel 33, we'll build it up. 23.
Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 23. Then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, they that inhabit those wastes of the land of Israel speak, saying,
what do they speak?
Abraham was one, and he inherited the land, but we are many. The land is given us for inheritance.
See, so Abraham will always come out their mouth. Abraham was one, inherited the land, we many. We gonna inherit this land, we gonna stay here. They were proud, right? What would Ezekiel be telling them? Repent.
Yep.
Go ahead.
25th verse. Wherefore say unto them, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, ye eat with the blood.
So what was Israel doing in the land?
Breaking the dietary law, eating with the blood.
Acting like Canaanites, drinking blood. How should our food be?
Well done.
Want some tartar and all this other, just oozing. Oh, that's healthy. Oozing with blood, man. Over here eating sushi. Cooked food. All this other stuff, man. Pink. That meat, brother, is not cooked. We say medium rare. We out of control, right? So we was in the land eating with the blood. Go ahead.
And lift up your eyes toward your idols.
And we was caught up into serving other gods, idols. Go ahead.
And shed blood.
So what else were we doing in the land?
Murdering
one another. We had that hate. But did Abraham come out their mouth?
Mm-hmm.
Did they speak Hebrew?
Yeah.
They knew what tribe they were from. Go ahead.
And ye shall possess the land.
And shall ye possess the land acting like this? Go ahead.
Ye stand upon your sword. Ye work abomination, and ye defile everyone his neighbor's wife.
What does that mean? What else were they doing?
Adultery.
Committing adultery. Fornicating. Go ahead.
And shall ye possess the land? Say unto them, say thou thus unto them. Thus saith the Lord God, as I live, surely they that are in the waste shall fall by the sword, and them that is in the open field will I give to the beast to be devoured, and they that be in the forts and in the caves shall die of pestilence. For I will lay the land most desolate, and the pauper strength shall cease, and the mountains of Israel shall be desolate, that none shall pass through. Then shall they know.
To say what, brother?
That none shall pass through. Then shall they know that I am the Lord.
Then shall they know I'm the Lord. When he did what?
Bring that judgment.
Bring that judgment. Oh, the Lord wasn't playing no games. Right? He said, then shall they know that I'm the Lord. Go ahead.
When I have laid the land most desolate, because of all their abominations which they have committed.
So would Israel want to repent?
No.
No. But Abraham came out their mouth. See what the prophet said? Always had to deal with the spirit, man. We're the Israelites. Okay. Does it stop there? There's more to it than that. We have to be born again. It starts with humility. We have to become as that child, right?
All right. Ezekiel said, in the 18th chapter, make you a new heart and a new spirit.
Why will you die, O house of Israel? That's right. See?
Continue. 30th verse. Also, thou son of man, the children of thy people still are talking against thee.
They still are doing what?
Talking against thee.
Well, it's also Ezekiel, you got Israelites talking against you. Mm-hmm. The Lord knew everything was going on.
Right.
Because Israel didn't want to repent. And the Lord set up Ezekiel as Israel's watchman and allowed them to like that. See? And they will be there doing what? We're going to read it. Go ahead.
It says, also, thou son of man, the children of thy people still are talking against thee by the walls and in the door of the houses, and speak one to another, everyone his brother, saying, come, I pray you, and hear what is the word that cometh forth from the Lord. And they come unto thee as the people cometh, and they sit before thee as my people, and they hear thy words, but they will not do this.
See the problem? Israel come here. But did they want to change their lives?
No.
They were proud. See? Challenging. Hard-headed. John the Baptist, they did all the same thing. Brother, what you think when the apostles went and taught? You would have proud Israelites that go against the gospel, right? Christ said, believe the gospel. You don't want to believe the gospel, that damnation coming, right? What is that, Mark 16?
Mm-hmm. Whoso believes and is baptized, the same shall be saved.
Whoso believes
not, the same shall be damned.
Bingo. So let's read 31 again.
The 31st verse say, and they come unto thee as the people cometh, and they sit before thee as my people, and they hear thy words, but they will not do them. For with their mouth they show much love.
They do what?
With their mouth they show much love.
See, so was Israel giving off that false appearance? Mm-hmm. With their mouth they show much love. All praises.
Lip service.
That lip service, man. That's us. But with their mouth they show much love, right? Go ahead.
But their heart goeth after their covetousness.
But their heart, Ezekiel, goeth after their covetousness.
And lust.
So it really is the Lord saying, they ain't really about changing their lifestyle. That's what was happening here during this time, in the time we're reading about with John the Baptist, so on and so forth, till Christ come back. Go ahead.
And lo, thou art up to them as a very lovely song of one that hath a pleasant voice.
So it was like John, Ezekiel's message was like, it's entertainment. Like this, oh, sound, yeah. But it wasn't about change. Go ahead.
And can play well on an instrument, for they hear thy words, but they do them not. And when this cometh to pass, Lord will come, then shall they know that a prophet hath been among them.
See that? And Ezekiel was a prophet. And this will continue to happen, Israel. The word goes out. A whole lot of our people refuse to repent, being proud, living that wicked lifestyle. Then comes judgment day. We don't want that. So let's go back to Matthew 3. Because Malachi said that day that the Lord that's going to come shall be a day of heat, man. Fire that shall leave neither branch nor root. Matthew 3:10. You can read verse 9 again, my brother.
And think not to say within yourselves, we have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you that Yahweh is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham. And now, also, the axe is laid unto the root.
The axe is laid to the what?
To the root of the trees.
The root of the trees. So who do these trees represent? Many Israelites. But if you put that axe to the root, that tree is a done deal, right?
Mm-hmm. Went to the prophecy.
Yeah. This is all Malachi 4. So the prophet spoke the same thing. Go ahead.
Therefore, every tree which bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire.
Does that sound tasty?
Not at all.
That sound like some good fire. Did it say it should cast into the good fire? No. That's judgment day, right? That's that eternal judgment. This is the doctrine of Christ. Remember it was said in Hebrews, this is the principle and oracles of God? So people, y'all got a gloomy doctrine and it's all doom and gloom. This is the gospel of the Most High Christ. This all comes from the heavens. But guess what? They heard that, didn't they? They still didn't want to change. So Christ come on the scene. Didn't they come at him? Same spirits. Same spirits, man. Today, same spirit. Go to in the Apocrypha, 2nd Ezra. Second Ezra 9:9. So this is in the Apocrypha. We always say it. You find this, the Apocrypha in the King James 16:11 edition. Here's another prophet. Ezra, 2nd Ezra 9:9.
2nd Ezra 9:9. Then shall they be in pitiful case.
Then shall they be in pitiful case. Meaning it's the time it's going to be gnashing of teeth. Judgment day.
Which now have abused my ways.
Which now have did what?
Abused my ways.
So what are ways of God that we can abuse and take lightly
His commandments.
Christ is the way. He showed us. Whatever he done, we to do. Christ's spirit that is in us, right?
Right.
We're supposed to follow it. Follow Christ, our head, our leader, our prince, our king. Lord said, then shall they be in pitiful case, which have now abused my ways. Look at the religions, what they're telling us. It's okay to abuse the ways of the Lord. They've done away with it. It's the new age. Live how you want to live. God knows your heart. What Christ said, tell us about our heart.
Out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders.
That's the carnal heart
from within.
Ezekiel said, change your what? Make you a new heart. See? Well, the Lord do know our heart. Read it again, brother.
Then shall they be in pitiful case, which thou have abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully.
And they that have cast them in the ways of God away despitefully
shall dwell in torment.
Shall dwell in what?
Torment.
Torments. Just that baptism of fire. For the Israelites that don't want to repent and follow the righteous ways of the Lord, right? So should we be casting the Lord's righteous ways from behind us?
No.
How do we do that, Israel? Words go out. Well, a lot of them throw pennies at us and
stop
the ears, challenge the message. Lord, he's showing us his ways. We cast him behind our back. I ain't doing it.
Right? Take it to a simple ourselves.
That's right. That's right, brother. That's deep.
Verse 10. For such as in their life have received benefits.
What does it mean about benefits? What are those? So for such in their life that have received benefits.
The blessings.
The good things. Look what I got. Look at this. I don't have to keep those commandments. Look. Easter coming. They ready, right? Go to the grocery store, all that. They got the what? The wicker basket. The chocolate bunnies. Right?
Right.
And in the colors. What is that? How did you say it? Pastel.
Pastel.
Yeah, the colors. The man gets you the colors. The colors. You say, wow, man, then you know when Christmas comes, it's red, green, you know, you have your sweater on. The red, green turtleneck.
Sweater.
Right? And then they get you with St. Patrick's Day. It's run around with a four-leaf clover on. Hey, Mike! Pinching people. Are you serious? Why you got on that grin? I don't want to be pinched. We was there, right? Straight wickedness. Did we ever challenge that stuff, man? We loved it. Christmas come up, Easter coming. You know, I was asking this. These clients the other day, man, say, rabbits lay eggs. 55, 30, 40. You know how we did it too. Damn, do we? Same perception, see? This man deals with perception. Sometimes we can't see things. The perception is off.
He uses it as witchcraft too.
That's what it is. Straight witchcraft. Spells. They still be on our people. Right? Go ahead, brother.
They teach Israel to go buy new clothes because that represents a new man.
Yeah. Do that. Yeah. They still be doing that stuff.
Hey, members only, Jackie?
Yeah. And then Israel learn they Israel, and then you see them, the bulk of them on Passover. Hey!
Hello.
That's the holy high holy day.
Hey!
Food on the table. Let's eat. Covetous, man. Other high holy days, Sabbath. We be playing, right?
Right.
The Lord is telling us we have to stop being worldly because such as in their life have received benefits. People get benefits, right? Different things, right? Go ahead.
It says, for such as in the life have received benefits and have not known me.
And have not known me.
and they that have loathed my law.
I know the Lord, my God, but when you come with the commandments,
loathe.
That ain't my God. Check what does loathe mean?
Hate.
Despise. Hate. Despise. Ooh, them commandments deeply.
What are we really doing?
Despising the commandments of God. See, for many of us, we like to do the hour. We
put on the blue water, the fringe, a beard, this and that,
hour stuff. Spirit inside, dirty. Deceitful. Covetous. This, all these things deal with the inside of us. We don't see that. Keep saying it, water baptism is a commandment of God. It's the same thing as breaking bread, drinking the wine. We do that. So what happened to the water?
Spice.
Yeah.
One faith, one baptism, it's all one.
That's right. So we gotta get busy. We gotta get busy, man. The Lord said, be not conformed to this Gentile world. That's what he's saying. That's the world he's talking about, the world of the Gentiles, this kingdom. We still be worldly. So to know the Lord is we knowing his ways, his nature, which is the keeping of his commandments. For such that have benefits and have not known me, and they that have loathed my law, these are the ones that have the benefits. Go ahead, also.
While they had yet liberty.
While they had still liberty, grace, time. Go ahead.
And when as yet place of repentance was open unto them.
When is that? When is the place of repentance? What time is that?
And now God hath commanded all men everywhere to repent.
That's right.
The time is now.
There it is.
John the Baptist started it off. But we're reading today.
Make haste.
That's right. I made haste and delayed not to keep thy commandments. It's time of repentance, man. It's the time we're supposed to be changing. Many of us, what? Want to change, man. So what has to take place? What did the Lord tell Ezra? Go ahead.
And when as yet place of repentance was opened up to them, understood not.
Understood not. So do our people really understand grace?
No.
And what grace is for? A lot of our people don't really understand repentance. Right?
Right.
That's why it has to be taught. A lot of Israelites, man, that know they Israel don't understand repentance. So we come with these phony doctrines, man. You got to get a Hebrew perspective to get a better understanding of the scriptures. Really? When Acts 2 cut the whole thing up, you had brothers, Peter, James, John, filled with the Holy Spirit. They could speak in the language or the tongue that our brothers and all that were born in the different countries and places where they were born at, right? They're like, man, how we hear the wonderful works of God in our own languages where we were born? They knew the law. That's why they came to keep Pentecost. Okay. Peter still told them to repent and get in that water. 3,000 humbled themselves. You see that? So to go to show you, man, you read about, let's finish this. We'll get some of that. Understood not, but what?
But despised it.
But despised that law. Go ahead.
The same.
Go ahead.
After death, by pain.
The same must know it. After death, by pain. How they gonna know it if they sleep?
Resurrection.
Right. And how are you going to wake up to pain? When the Lord ain't talking about a headache. Wake up, headache. You've been asleep for so long. Nah, judgment. We don't want that. We want to get the understanding, man, through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit and say, Lord, show us what we got to do. Open up my eyes that I may behold wondrous things out of thy law. Hebrew. Tally Hootie, this. Missing it. The gospel, man. Go to Revelation 14. The gospel of repentance comes in many forms and in many languages. We learn the doctrine of repentance through the language we speak. Lord said, with stammering lips and another tongue will I speak to this people. Gotta know the Hebrew. We're in Revelation. The chip. Revelation 14 and 6.
It says, and I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach us.
So right there, sorry. Here's the Apostle John seeing a vision coming from the Most High Christ. Well, he's seeing an angel having an everlasting gospel to preach. Go ahead.
To preach unto them that dwell on the earth and to every nation.
And to every nation, meaning the gospel will be going out to all nations, because where Israel at?
Scattered amongst all nations.
Scattered amongst all nations. Go ahead.
And kindred.
And kindred.
And tongue.
And who?
Tongue. And people.
See, so how would these Israelites hear the gospel? In different languages and tongues, right?
Right.
Go ahead. So what the gospel entail?
Say with a loud voice, fear God and give glory to him. For the hour of his judgment is come.
For the hour of his what?
Judgment is come. And worship him that made heaven and earth and the sea and the fountains of waters.
Christ already told us how to worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Follow Christ. That entails the keeping of the commandments. Fear God, but we don't want to do it. We're going to face the judgment. We hear the gospel in our tongue and where we're born. We hear, we know English. We hear it in English today. See, you had great teachers that would be born in different areas, brother, throughout the earth, and could push that gospel. Look at Aquila. Where was he born at? Pontus. Remember in Acts 2 they said Pontus and all that? Had brothers, sisters born in different areas. Aquila was a cold-blooded teacher with his wife, Priscilla. Mm. They stepped in and dealt with Apollos.
Born in Alexandria.
Where was Apollos born?
Alexandria.
That's an Egypt. Was he a powerful teacher?
Yep.
Mighty in the scriptures. See, they miss all. Israel be sleeping on all that. And this brother, Apollos, could go on the streets, brother, publicly, and show by the scriptures that Yahweh is the Christ. He ain't used gimmicks and books. These books. The law and the prophets, wham, hitting Israel. And he allowed himself to be taught by Aquila and them. And he learned God way more perfectly. Humility, man. So it was the spirit, brothers, sisters. So man talking, you already know, we learned Deuteronomy 28 in what? Hebrew? Brothers, you can teach whole classes, brother. Lashawan Kwadash, say prayers. Lashawan Kwadash, go through the book of Numbers. Read four lines, four verses. Abba, kata, ma, do, ha, do, do. What happened? Did they get a Hebrew perspective? And what? We voted. Brother, come up in here, can't play no basketball with strength shoes. What you doing? Oh, it's the Sabbath. Nothing. He got on strength shoes. But to do calf muscle. Brother, are you serious? You're getting mad. We ain't supposed to be on the Sabbath working out. I ain't working out. No hops. What you doing? So you just put on the strength shoes, sitting in the corner. We got to repent. That's what we're talking about. Man, how do you know Jesus Christ wore fringes? Show them the script. They ain't say French. challenge. For others, no. Bad attitude. Then you got brothers come up in here, yeah, teachers. Yeah, you know, taking men out to Pry America. Y'all know what Pry America is? On the Sabbath day. Hey, you ain't gotta go to go to Pry America. See? I'm telling you, man, we want to look like Frederick Douglass. Right? Where he at? Egyptology. God repent. I'm talking about Christ as a false deity God. Come on, man. Brothers, no. Sisters, no. In and out. Plain. It's the gospel. We gotta repent. Gotta repent, man, and we take things lightly. So it's telling us we can't despise the law, we can't despise the gospel. Okay? So the scripture that came out, if you read Acts 18, Acts 19, they show you had many Israelites in Italy, in Rome. We get kicked out, then we go, we was in Corinth, Asia Minor, different places, Ephesus, we over here. So is that 12 tribe sign wrong?
Yes.
Yeah. Because you had a mighty teacher, Apollos, who's in the Bible. He was born in Egypt. You don't have Egypt on that sign. Quilla was born in Pontus. You don't have that on that sign. It ain't men talking about the sign represents the two sticks. So you got the two sticks in the back. See, it's in Ezekiel. They made up some stuff. And they still pushing that same stuff, Israel. The same stuff. And this one brother, he got to repent. Elderly brother, he said, you don't have to keep the commandments. Y'all under the old covenant. The new covenant is about grace. You're right. Commandments come with the new covenant, right?
Right.
Out of Christ's mouth, the brother, the young brother asked him, what must I do to inherit eternal life? What did Christ say?
That will enter into life, keep the commandments.
And he ran them off. Are you that man gonna come up and say, that's Moses' law? Serious, Israel? So we don't want that judgment. So let's be careful.
Go to 2 Thessalonians. Just dealing with the baptism of fire and judgment day. Because as we see, you know, if you've been paying attention, judgment day, like we read in Malachi, is not nothing new. And that just didn't, Christ just didn't come up with that. Because that was already prophesied in the scriptures like we read. But then when we understand further the scriptures, because you got a lot of non-Messianics that don't believe in Christ. Which is fine. You know, not saying it's acceptable, but they can believe whatever they want to believe. You understand according to the scriptures, there's two lords in heaven, in the heavens. And when we understand about judgment, then we understand that in Isaiah 66, it said, the Lord shall come with flaming fire and vengeance. And when we understand Psalms 110, we understand that's the second Lord that's sitting by the right-hand side of the Most High, Christ. So when Christ comes back, it says, 2 Thessalonians 1 and 6, it says, seeing it is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. It says, and to you who are troubled, rest with us. When the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels. See? And that's all throughout the scriptures. That's just not something that Paul's making up in Thessalonians or writing to the church of Thessalonica. You can go all throughout the scriptures and we can show that this Lord Jesus is the Lord of heaven and earth. See, Christ, that was written about in the Old Testament. So it says, and to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels. And when we understand that scriptures, Christ is coming from the heaven of heavens. He's not coming from outer space.
Wow.
The Lord and the angels are above the heavens. Scriptures tell you that I think it's in Revelation that it says that the heavens were opened. The same heavens that Stephen saw. He wasn't looking out in the outer space and seeing the stars. He was seeing something way different than we ever seen in our life. That heavens opened up, and Christ and the angels just gonna come through. This man ain't gonna have no time to load his weapons, get his armies, load up his missiles. It's gonna happen just like that. We gonna look up there, the sky gonna open up, and here come Christ, boom. No radars, no sonic, boom, and none of that stuff is happening. That heavens is gonna open up that dimension, and here they come. Then it says, verse 8, a flaming fire taking vengeance on them that know not the Most High, and that obey not the what?
Gospel of our Lord
Jesus Christ. So, is it a serious thing when we just went over the scriptures in Revelation, what was that, 12?
14
and 6, about the gospel being preached? So, what's going to happen to those that don't obey the gospel?
They're going to be destroyed.
They're going to be destroyed. By Jesus Christ, by the Lord. See? So when we think the apostle doctrine is just cliche, and it's not a cliche. What gospel were the apostles teaching? The gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It says, and obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. So the ones that don't obey the gospel, we read in 2 Esdras chapter 9. What's going to happen? We're going to be destroyed. It says, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the power and from the glory of his power. When he shall come to be what? Glorified in his saints and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day. What was the testimony of the apostles?
The gospel, death, resurrection, ascension of Christ.
Exactly. They were testifying of Christ. Death, resurrection, and ascension. What was it called in Acts? The Apostles' Doctrine. See? So, we just got to remember that. Just live every day like it's literally the last, because we don't know. How soon do we know that we can look up, walk outside, and heavens is opening. Here come that trump, it's over. See? But this world and Satan is deceived us to think, we got time. We got an extension on the loan or on the contract. You don't know that. Most High didn't give us no guarantees on how long this thing is going to take place, how long it's going to take for Christ to come. It don't take Christ 30 minutes to get here. That's what we think. It takes Christ 3 days to get here. Like, we got time to prepare. You'd be here in 30 minutes. Come on, let's go, guys. It's not going to happen like that. Thieves don't give you warnings when they break in the house. You look up, you turn over, and they're over your bed. They at you. And they gone. So we just got to keep a lot of things in memory or in mind. This thing ain't to be played with. We act like it can be played with, and then when he come, we don't want to be the ones on the other side of the coin like, I needed more time. Because he gave us time. You know, we always preach that our life is but a vapor, a shadow. See? We here today, we gone tomorrow. And we gotta think of it always in those terms. Because the Lord, he ain't guaranteeing, he ain't granting us nothing. But the kingdom if we want it. You know. Now I just end with this. A lot of us been around a long time. Some of us in our 30s, some of us in our 40s, in our 20s. And when you put things into perspective, when the Lord said life is short, he means exactly that. Some of us, what? 30, 40? You know, some of us heading toward 50. That ain't long, man. And we ain't got that much longer to go. If you really think about it. You know, I was thinking about this the other night. You know, I'm in my 30s. And if you think about it in terms of how short this thing is, the Lord tells us each day that go by, we got to take advantage of it. Especially when it comes to time. We don't want to waste no time. You know, every day that go by is a day we don't get back. And children, you look up, they're going to be gone. They're going to be grown, and we're going to be gone. You know, and every month that goes by is another month that the Lord has given us for us to get it right. If you do the math, I myself have been alive 456 months. I'm just telling you. I'm not allowed to think in these terms. But if the Lord give me another 40 years, that means I only got 480 months to go. That ain't a long time. And each month that go by, each day that go by, the Lord is saying, you know what? Chalk that up in the records, in the bank. So we don't want to take these times, these precious moments that the Lord has given us, and wasted. We went over this a long time ago. I remember this lesson. We was over there in the other class when we had in the brick house. And we was going over friendship. And we was talking about how we don't want to waste time. We got all this time and we got this special opportunity with each other to become better friends, better brothers, better wives, better husbands. We got the gospel to show us how to make these things happen. And we use that time that the Lord gave us to be hating, be angry, be frustrated. It don't make no sense. And that's just wasted time. I'm not going to spend 20 years in here with people that I don't like. That don't even make no sense, man. 20 years and I've come to figure out I don't like you. It's stupid, man. It's just stupid statement. I'm just telling you, it is. It's stupid. 20 years, I realized I don't even like this person. Like, what kind of backwards thinking is that? Or have I been deceived to think I don't like this person? See? So, that day is coming. Everything we went over today, the Lord prophesied, long before we crossed over into Jordan, Most High had already told it to Moses. It happened. That took place. It didn't take place during Moses' time, but it happened. See, so everything that this book is talked about, eventually it comes to pass in due time. And if we think that that day is not coming, we're kidding ourselves. We think we can play around and this man is going to protect us, or at the end we're going to escape, we're going to know in the end we're going to suffer it after death by how? Pain.
Hey.
So we just want to consider those things. Take the time we got with each other and make the most of it, man. We focus so much on the negativity because that's what we've been taught and misled through the gospel. That's not what the scriptures teach. We focus on we always focus and make the negativity the focal point instead of focusing on how can we do and what can we do to make this thing better. So that's it. Anybody else?
Just really quick to expand on, like, on the seals.
Say it again.
The seals, like the six, seven seals. About talking about when Christ comes. I mean, each seal is, you know, when it opens up, you know, is it in consecutive time or is it all gonna be in like in one thing, like in one moment, one instant?
What seals are you talking about?
Like in the Revelation, like, you know, the angels pour out, you know, the spirit, and then, you know, talking about. I don't know, like, I think it's in Revelations 7, I think, when they're talking about, like, the angels, you know, we're working through tribulation, we're fighting tribulation, and after, you know.
Right, so you're talking about the seals that was on the book.
Yeah.
And Christ could open them all the seals up.
Yeah.
Seven seals is the judgment day.
Okay.
You can read about that in Revelation 11.
Yeah.
The 11th chapter. That's the time we're talking about. This class. So we should be worried about repenting so we ain't trying to get caught up in that last seal. And that's Revelation 11. Whatever that is. Last trump.
Right.
I should say. Last trump.
Alright. Come on, my 5 minutes. Okay, let's break bread.
Alright, let's go.